Law of Conservation of Momentum. Objective: to learn the law of conservation of momentum. Momentum is defined as the motion of the mass of an object. Because all objects have mass, any moving object will also have momentum. The law of conservation of momentum states that the total momentum of two or more objects acting upon one another will not change, provided there are no external forces acting on them. In other words, when two objects collide, their total momentum before the collision will be the same as the total momentum after the collision. Let's consider two cars of different masses, a bigger one, M1, and a smaller one, M2. Imagine the cars are moving in the same direction, but with different velocities, U1 and U2 respectively. Because momentum is the product of mass and velocity, the momentum of the bigger car can be expressed as M1 into U1. And the momentum of the smaller car can be expressed as M2 into U2. To determine the total momentum of both cars would be M1 U1 plus M2 U2. Now, let's imagine that our two cars are colliding. During the collision, the bigger car will exert a force F1 on the smaller car, and the smaller car will exert a force F2 on the bigger car. As a result of the collisions, the velocities of the cars will change. So, we'll represent those as V1 and V2. Force is the product of mass and acceleration. In our example of the collision, the force of the bigger car will be expressed as F1 is equal to M1 into V1 minus U1 by T, with T representing time. The force of the smaller car during the collision will be expressed as F2 is equal to M2 into V2 minus U2 by T. According to the Newton's third law, each action will have an action that is equal and opposite, meaning the forces can be expressed as F1 is equal to minus F2. Because both forces are equal and opposite, we can also write them as M1 into V1 minus U1 by T is equal to minus M2 into V2 minus U2 by T. We can cancel T, the common factor of time in the equation. M1 into V1 minus U1 is equal to minus M2 into V2 minus U2. The equation can then be simplified. M1 V1 minus M1 U1 is equal to minus M2 V2 plus M2 U2. And it can be written as M1 into V1 plus M2 into V2. Is equal to M2 into U2 plus M1 into U1. From this equation, we can see the total momentum for both cars before and after the collision did not change but was conserved, thereby proving the law of conservation of momentum. Summary: the law of conservation of momentum states that the total momentum of two or more objects acting upon each other does not change, provided no external forces act upon them.